Did you get a chance to superimpose that on the building yet?
No, I can't find a picture of it.
Are you serious?
No, I've looked through everything. I don't have one picture of that mural.
If we went out to the garage and took a picture?
Is it up?
It's leaning. Don't frame for it.
If everyone would please join us for the pledge of the flag. Thank you. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everyone. Anyone wishes to address the board, they may do so by signing in for public speaks. And with that said, that's Mr. Walsh, call the roll.
Mr. Stevens?
Here.
Mr. Lockhart?
Here.
Mr. Camp?
Here.
Attorney Matthews?
Here.
Chief Brown?
Here.
Captain Urien?
Here.
Mr. Sims?
Here.
Mr. Melito?
Here.
Mrs. Simon?
Here.
Mrs. Left?
Here.
Okay. I did welcome everyone, but since I've been programmed for 14 or 15 days in this kind of mode, why I'll say aloha. Now, what's with this weather? I'm freezing. First order of business would be the minutes of the last meeting. Where are my notes? That's the name in here. Can't find them. We've all been issued the minutes of the October 22nd meeting for review. Corrections or additions?
I have none, sir.
I have none.
Hearing none then, do we have a motion to accept the minutes as presented?
I'll make that motion.
Do we have a second?
Second, sir.
Call the roll.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Abstain. Financials.
Okay, total pending warrants were $118,788.08.
Questions, comments on the bills?
I have none, sir.
I have none, sir.
We've had a chance to review those.
Yes, sir.
Sign those. So with that said, we have a motion to pay the bills as submitted.
I'll make that motion.
We have a second.
Second.
Call the roll.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes. Other financials.
Total receipts and balances were $3,132,359.46. Expenditures of $118,788.08. With an ending balance of $3,013,571.38.
Questions on balance and receipts?
I have none.
I have none either, sir.
Hearing none, I'll move that we approve the balance and receipts as presented by this officer.
I'll second that.
Call the roll.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Additional.
Okay, resolution or the following purchase orders. Crystal Reichert, $1,800. Pennington Bank, $900. Other expenses in the general fund, $2,000. And Ohio Edison for tornado sirens, $750.
Any questions on those?
No, I'll make a motion to approve.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Call the roll.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Okay, and then we have, I gave you all a copy of the rates from the county auditor. We need a resolution accepting the amounts and rates as determined by the budget commission and authorizing the necessary tax levies and certifying them to the county auditor.
Is that two motions or?
Just one motion.
Okay. Do you gentlemen have any questions for?
Do they look all right?
Pardon?
Do they look like they're?
Yeah.
In order?
Yes, because I have
additional discussion or questions? Hearing none, call roll.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
And then, we need a motion for a new furnace for administration building, not to exceed $5,000. Our furnace hasn't been working upstairs.
I'll make that.
And it's gonna be for air on mechanical services?
Yes, I'll make that one.
Do we have a second?
Second.
New furnace, okay, discussion. Lester did inform me a little bit about what was taking place. Is that furnace covered by the building?
No, just half of that upstairs, I believe. Because the meeting room furnace still works. But like this morning, the front office, it was 60 only for me.
Okay, so there, that's one furnace of a couple, is that three?
Yeah, there's three.
Oh, there's three furnaces?
So that'd be one of three.
So like, I hope that ain't a stir of it.
Yeah.
Well, I thought the original estimate was around four.
Yeah, it shouldn't go over four.
But she did say something about not to exceed five, just to make sure.
Yeah, but it shouldn't go over four.
Okay, but that's, and now these furnaces were all original?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so.
We had trouble with this one last year.
You did mention that in our conversation, so.
It was about $1,400 or $1,500 to repair this one. And then we weren't sure, so.
Okay, hearing any additional comments? You wanna go ahead and make the motion then for this?
Yeah, I'll make the motion to not exceed $5,000 on that furnace.
Who is the provider again?
Air on Mechanical Services.
Okay, do we have a second?
Yes.
Call roll.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
And then we need a motion to approve the purchase of a transcription package from Norrison for the secretary's computer at a cost not to exceed, at a cost of $371.50.
So what was this one for?
The transcription.
Oh, yeah, we talked about that, yeah. But she'd have it at her desk also.
Right.
You guys understand.
Yeah, so she could do it there instead of going back.
That was the memo from?
Marita?
Okay, yeah, I reviewed that. You made the motion to go ahead. I'll second that. Call roll.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
And then I need a motion for a work session on insurance, November 5th at 3:30, before the regular meeting.
Now, this is with?
This is with DeStefano.
Okay.
3:30?
Mm-hmm.
Any issue there, any?
Yes. What day was that?
It's November 5th, Monday, before the regular meeting.
That's another cataract day.
Okay.
Okay.
We'll handle it for you, Les.
Yes, I'm not here that day.
In fact, while we're meeting, why hopefully your insurance is still in play.
That's true. No, they don't cover it. That's $4,000.
Oh, moving right along.
Not information.
Don't wanna go there, but we will cover it, if that's all right with you, sir.
That's fine.
If you have to have your surgery, please, I would suggest go ahead and do that.
I'll make that motion. Have a work session, November 5th, 3:30, discuss insurance, DeStefano.
DeStefano, second that. Call roll.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
And that's here?
Yes.
Okay.
Then as well, what's the next one? November 19th, have a work session before the meeting to go over the budget for 2019 at 3:30.
What time would you like that?
3:30.
So that's, what date is that?
That would be November 19th.
Second meeting of the month?
Second meeting of the month.
So it's a Monday also?
That might not be. Is that right after Thanksgiving or before?
Before.
Oh, I'll be here, okay.
I'll move that we set the date for a budget hearing, budget, I should say, meeting, work session at 3:30.
I'll second.
On the 19th. Call roll.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes. You'll send out memos?
Yes.
Reminders?
Yep.
Sticky notes.
Other items?
That's all I have.
No correspondence.
No correspondence.
Okay, that's just the trustees' business. I would like to thank the police department. Did get a call while I was on vacation regarding the possibility of getting, what is our machine called?
A speed trailer.
Speed trailer. Possibly getting our speed trailer up on
Cheriton.
And so I called the township police department. I took the vocal message, voicemail, and it was kind of chopped up. I'm not so sure if it was my phone or somebody else's phone or whatever, but I got a hold of Officer Wright and explained the situation, and so I got a thank you call for getting that up there Tuesday when I got back. So I want to say thank you to the police department for following through on that. And how long do you leave these things in place before you do a reading or you do any kind of?
About a week, so tomorrow or Wednesday we'll call it and move it.
Okay. Okay, well, party involved was very pleased about that in hopes that it maybe will give an indication of speed, volume of cars, and so on. So, thank you. Good job, well done.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I have nothing else to report at this time, except I had a wonderful time on vacation and didn't think about this place at all. When you're 5,000 miles away and you're in 89 degree temperature, sitting on the beach, watching the scenery, and my lovely wife, and drinking ice water. What do you take? Drinking ice water.
When you're 6 hours different, so it don't make no difference.
Yes, but a very, very, very eventful, nice trip. I will say one thing that was kind of interesting, and I don't mean to be labored, a couple of days earlier. The area we stayed at, not on Maui, but on the other island, Oahu, as we drove out, we were about 45, 50 miles outside of the city of Honolulu. We started to see a lot of tents, a lot of mid-rigged plywood shanties, jacked up cars. Well, here was homeless folks. Many, many, many miles of homeless folks along the beach. And the reason I'm bringing it up, because I think it ties in with governments here, we found out from talking to the locals that resorts around Honolulu and on Waikiki Beach and Diamond Head were not happy with the amount of homeless folks that were around the area there and congregating. So they shipped them up to the northern portion of the island where we were at. And so I thought that was kind of interesting that the government took it upon themselves to do that. And one other item that was mentioned, that several states evidently had given their residents, especially states like New York, said the bigger cities, cold cities, Detroit, Chicago, one-way tickets, give their homeless one-way tickets to come out and go to Hawaii. Now, I thought that was really interesting. Now, this came from the residents, not from any concrete other than these folks saying, yeah. But they were all rather upbeat and saying, if you're going to be homeless, why not be homeless in Hawaii? Look at the temperature and so on. But we had a wonderful stay and we got enlightened on that activity. And so Hawaii is a beautiful place. Just make sure you take a wheelbarrow full of money, because you'll need it. With that said, Mr. Walker.
I have nothing tonight, sir.
Okay, you had a roll last week. Mr. Camp.
Okay. I want to thank Road Superintendent Jim Sims here for, we got the fence up. I don't know if you knew that, out there around the
cemetery. I knew you were having a work day. You
yeah,
had talked
we
about
did it in about, when everybody was there and everything rolling, we did it in about 3 hours. So if you get a chance, I know that Joan, maybe somebody from the newspaper, go out and see it. It really turned out nice. I was really pleased with it. But I want to thank Bro got a big rock out there right now. I did a little investigating, and if you guys want, this is the material. So there's no actually like metal kind of stuff. And I was going to go with a QR reader. I never did hear from Drew. So. But anyhow, so we're going to do the names on a 2x4 sign. And it's the 2x4 sign with all the setup and everything, which is $241. So that's much cheaper than the other way. And I'll either just screw it to the fence or I'll cement it on that big rock. So I'm not sure what we're going to do with it yet. So how we're going to do it. But if it's okay, I don't. We had the fence was around $2,000. We think we got another $1,000 between machinery and everything.
Machinery and stuff, yeah, about $1,000.
So that's three. So then Akron U just got a letter. We got a letter off to Akron U with all the names. From what I understand, they'd like to come November 6th. That's the day after my surgery, so I don't know if we can get any help from maybe road crew. I'll help a little bit out there or not. That if they do come that day, and they're going to go out and try to place the rocks with the graves that's laying there. We're just going to lay them all flat that's left. We had, what, two or three truckloads of bases.
Yeah, it's about three loads.
But it looks much nicer, I think. I appreciate if some of you can take a run out there and look at it, but I think I'm still in my budget to get this 241. That's, you know, we talked that $1,000, we'll just, somebody break it up. That has no metal, I don't think, in it at all, so it's some kind of Lexian or something.
And this next step is to recognize on this plaque then, or piece, the people that are buried there?
Yeah, we have like row 1, 2, 3, it says all the names. We'll put all the names on that plaque and we'll just put in memory of these people on the plaque. So if anybody else wants to see what the material is, but that was much cheaper. The other way would have only been $91 for the QR reader, but nobody seems to be able to figure out how to do it yet. I know they do it because they did it up at the Veterans Cemetery. But if that's okay with the two board members.
Yeah, we allocated some money and said go for it, so
okay,
you seem to be moving along, and
we should be way below what it says.
I have a question. What is the name of this cemetery again?
Clover Hill.
Now, we're doing these things. We had that conversation, I think, a while back about what we do after this. That being, it's not an active cemetery. I'm talking about the status of it.
All we'll do now, since we're laying all, if I'm right, there'll still be some monuments up. Okay, the ones that we can at least try to straighten back up, we'll straighten up. And some of them are up, but most of them are all going to be flat, dug in the ground with the grave markers up, and they can mow over it easy. There'll be very little maintenance other than just mowing.
So we'll still keep, for lack of better, responsibility, ownership of it?
Yes. Yeah, we do still.
Okay. That said, I know Mr. Matthews had researched on a different approach we could take. Is that cemetery ever going to be used for?
Well, here's
we make that decision, or how would that go?
Here's a new thing coming out since you brought that up. Lindsay Concrete is making concrete, like you see at the post office in Canal Fulton, you see them, you put your mail in them boxes. That'll be for urns. If we ever want to do it, you could.
Like cluster boxes?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's grants out there now to get the cluster box, and you could actually sell lots there. There's enough room that you could put one of them cluster boxes up there, and we could sell some lots to make some, not lots, to put your urn in. In other words, they don't bury the urns. They're not going to bury the urns in the ground anymore most places. They'll be up here. And Lindsay Concrete came up with this idea, I guess. And right now, Tufts Township is putting in a grant to get this. There is grant stuff coming up to put these cluster boxes. So, you know, right now we don't have no room to actually plant, you know, bury more people. But if we could put a cluster box out there and make some money if somebody wanted to be buried there.
Just so I, and I'm sorry if I seem to be not up to speed, but just so I understand, I mean, I know we all talked about, held hands about improvement and wanting it to be respectful and getting it that way. I didn't know after we did that what our thoughts were on how we're going to continue and proceed, whether we can close it up and declare it. I'm looking to Jim for some guidance on how that went.
Yeah, you're actually not closing it.
No.
So you're not going to treat it as an abandoned cemetery and close it, meaning no further. You decided to follow what everybody thought was a good course of making it clean, getting it clean, making it respectful, and then you'll just have a minimal obligation of maintenance. On the Ohio Department of Commerce website, under the cemetery tab, there is a link for the best practices for minimal care of a non-active but maintained cemetery. It's a single sheet of instructions, and it's just the typical things that you would think about. Mowing on occasion, making sure that limbs, debris, that type of thing, that's picked up. And then any painting of physical structures. The fence that you put up, it may be a maintenance-free one, maybe it doesn't need painting, but...
It won't, it's cedar.
Oh, okay, yeah, see, something like that will be a lot easier to care for.
Well, when you say, what was that word, not...
It's not an abandoned, it's still a listed cemetery. But it's also not an active cemetery. If you want to make it an active cemetery, you'll need to re-register it with the Department of Commerce.
I guess that's where I'm going with it, with what he's asking about, because I don't know.
Well, you have to put so much of your funds into it, too. It gets infected, but I just, if that'd be something someday we wanted to do since they came out with this.
Oh, okay, that's just an FYI.
Oh, no, this is just that you brought it up.
Just an FYI, okay.
And that would be something that I don't think we do, but...
It's an option.
Yeah.
Okay.
They just came up with this idea. Lindsay Concrete came up.
And then that said, and that helps me understand where we're going with it, what we're going to be doing. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, again, thank you to all you guys for your efforts and what you did. If we're going to put this plaque up, this piece up on the rock, is there anything that identifies the cemetery as... the name of it. That's why I had to ask you.
There's a big sign out front that says Clover Hill Cemetery.
Very good. So that's in place. So it's identifiable from the sign. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
This sign would just say a memory of those here, and then they'd have the listing of the names. If you want to go out there and see who actually, the best that we can acknowledge from the paperwork we have, that's who would be there.
Very good.
I thought the 240 wasn't too bad.
Oh, no, it does.
Putting about 60 names is what would be on that plaque.
That what that cemetery holds, about 60?
Well, that's what we know of.
You know of?
Yeah, I didn't count them out, to tell you.
Well, I just, just ask.
But we do have some more monument bases. When hopefully Akron U goes ahead with this, that we can pick up. It looks a lot nicer just now. Not even, I think so. You guys were there, so you can see. But
yeah, it does. It does.
Everybody worked so good. That's why I took my time. I wasn't going to come, but I wanted to thank everybody personally. It was very good.
And thank you for explaining out the status where we're at.
The other thing that just came up was pretty much for active cemeteries, it's in existence now. But if we ever wanted to get some money out of it, it would be paperwork, I think. So I don't know if you want to do that. But okay, my next thing is we have a Boy Scout. His name is Kiko. He wants to build I think I might have talked to Frank one time about this. He has the blueprints and everything over Chapel Cross. He wants to build a pavilion. Well, he's going to need a zoning permit. Do you know if we could waive the permit for this, or is this something? Did I talk to you about this before?
No, I don't think so, but it probably would be something that Mr. Matthews would want to answer. I don't know that we've ever waived one before, but...
You can ordinarily waive for other political subdivisions that are in the township, but private entities, churches and such, you kind of wind up on a slippery slope there. I think
think you would still have within your discretion to waive a fee if you wanted to. But I'm not sure what the circumstances were. Typically, you should tie it to some need or something like that.
Is there any thought? Do you guys have any thought on this? Because he's got to go through regional, like, I think, for a pavilion. He has to go to the building permit.
I'm hearing what Jim's saying, and I heard slippery slope.
Right.
And we've been on those before.
We can donate that. I'll donate the fee here.
Should be $40.
Yeah, I'll just donate that fee.
Lester, thank you. That's handled.
Thank you.
I.
Yeah, but I mean, that way it gets done without getting stuck.
Yeah, well, I didn't want to get it politically tied up in a whole lot. You just unknotted it.
Yeah.
Next subject. Thank you.
I'll take care of that.
Yeah, God bless you.
North Lawrence School. There's something going on over there. I don't know what it is. Are they putting a roof on it? Did they get a permit?
No, they wouldn't need, Jim called me the other day, and they're adding another floor, I think.
I know, but does anybody know if he got one of those?
Well, he wouldn't need a zoning permit to go up high.
That's a good statement.
He would need a building.
How do we check on this?
Well, I can call.
Okay, would you do?
You don't have an address.
No, it's the old schoolhouse. I don't know. But right next door, there's a church coming up for sale next week, or next month.
Church?
Yeah, they closed the church downtown, and we're sure praying. He does a crazy act, don't buy that too. Because that would really make it up. So anybody who wants a church, please show up at that meeting. I mean, I don't know what we do if he gets it.
Is it an active church?
They just voted to close it. There was only 7 members left, so it was an old church. Anybody who wants any historical items, they're trying to find somebody to take because they have a lot of stuff about North Lawrence there, about the church. If anybody would know, I don't know, maybe the historical.
The fire department's got a nice big building to display stuff there.
So.
Just a thought. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah. The next one is mobile homes. Do we do mobile homes in Lawrence Township?
Stark County Health Department. When you say do, you mean?
I mean new ones, putting new ones in. Do we allow, is that in zoning?
No.
So they can do that? Instead of a home, they can put a building?
No.
Is that what just?
Mobile home park is regulated by Stark County Health Department.
Okay.
Doesn't sound like that's what you're asking.
Well, there was a double wide. I don't know if it was made out of wood or what on Orville Street.
Oh, no, that's a.
Those are modular homes.
That's just a modular home.
It's not a mobile home.
No, it's a modular home.
All right, thank you.
Must have been talking to John. Talking to John.
Yeah.
It was some.
Cemetery update, I just gave that. Okay, I think that's all I have. I want to thank everybody personally. If you get a chance, please go at least see it.
Thank you.
Quite an impression.
Trustee Camp for spearheading that and everyone that says that they're helping. Yeah, we'll give you time at the end of your meeting.
Yeah, I got a mind up.
No, that's all right. You are under the influence, we understand. I'm always like this, so. Fire Department.
Just one thing, trustees. The chief wanted me to get approval to get our fit tester certified. And I gave the fiscal officer the invoice. And he's asking that 2-week notice be waived on that since we do need to have that.
What kind of money are you talking about?
$810.
And what is it again for?
It's a fit tester for our SCBA mask that each individual wears. We make sure that each individual passes the test to be able to wear that. So that's new hires and.
I can't remember whether he did or not.
I know he talked to us about it, but is this the first reading or?
Yeah, he asked it to be waived and if he brought it up, just a discussion more.
Yeah.
If you guys heard it, it's good enough for me.
Yeah.
Normally they don't come at us like this.
Yeah.
They do the 2-week test, so.
I know he brought it up, so.
The provider is?
OHD.
OHD in the amount of $810. You gentlemen have any problems with this? Okay, I'll make a move that we approve the request by Captain Arion for the fire department. They're calling this a Q-Fit annual calibration. Is that what this thing is called?
Yes, it's a device that actually, you hook up to a mask and it goes through a series of tests to make sure the individual passes.
Right, well, that's critical. Any the amount of $810, so I'll move that we approve this. Do we have a second?
Second.
Call the roll.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes. I did think of it, if I can go back to that one.
Is that all you had, Tom?
Yes.
Okay, and before we get to Rich, yes, sir, so you don't forget.
I want to thank the ones that came to the Y event the other night, the horses are racing, they sold out quite a group. If you ever get a chance to go to market, people were having a hoot of a time, I'll tell you. And I just want to thank everybody. We were represented as a township, mayor's here, so I wanted to hear this, as a township, very good. Problem was, the city never showed up. So I don't understand that, Mayor.
I didn't want to gamble.
Huh?
I didn't want to gamble.
No, I don't mean you, there wasn't one council member there.
Yeah.
Not one, really, but we had very good representation from our township.
Well, I can only say I had no money left from vacation.
Well, you didn't.
Whether I'd have been in town or not, my horse is still running someplace in Hawaii, so.
He might get tired from it.
I would, as much as I'd like to have been there to contribute, my money's.
No, I just said that.
No, I've heard of the Knights of the Races thing.
I never heard of it.
Well, we're glad to hear it was a profitable, lucrative endeavor and fun.
Yeah, it was fun, and.
They realized we had so many gamblers in the town. Well, they sure beat me up when I was talking about a casino, though. I wasn't talking about the casino, I just wanted to keep it on the table.
I want to thank everybody, it really was a successful night, everybody had a good time, I think, and.
Very good.
And I don't gamble much, but she didn't even, she just helped out.
Very good.
Thank you.
Rich?
For the fire department, don't really have anything. Interesting fact, when they tore the deck off the bridge, one of the spans did collapse into the dune spring.
Oh my.
So.
It was a need, it was a need.
They've got all the supports across it out, and they said they were going to be putting the other ones in this week.
Now, do they still look for that December? I thought I read it so in the minutes since I've been back. December 18th completion date, is that still realistic?
They're still open for right before Thanksgiving.
Oh, before Thanksgiving.
But they do have a December 10th deadline to be there, then they're on penalty, but they're still hoping right before.
Okay.
And they are working.
Oh, they're a good crew.
Friday night, they were there till like 6 or so.
Yeah, they're good.
Before they quit work and getting everything out. And they told me that they would have the, they put the other spans in this week.
Yeah, they're a good crew.
So they're moving along pretty good.
Very good, I'm sure you folks will be happy to see that.
Very happy.
Wrapped up, yes. Well, thank you, and glad everything's going, hopefully quiet. We have, before our next meeting, we have trick or treat coming up. I don't know what takes place down your way. You kind of coincide since most of North Lawrence, if not all of it's in the township.
Yeah.
Coordinated.
Yeah, they go with that.
Fire, police, everybody's on the same page. The city, our safety forces, everybody's in sync there.
We usually have guys going around North Lawrence.
Okay.
To make sure everybody stays safe.
Hopefully the weather will cooperate and a decent day for that, or evening and so on. So I did read in something where everybody will be doing the same thing, and that all the safety force people and so on will be out. So very good. All right, police department.
Thank you. Just one thing this evening. We have two cruisers we don't use anymore. They're parked in the back of our lot. 2011 Ford Crown Vic and 2008 Ford Crown Vic. Like approval to sell those at auction at Skipco on November 10th.
I'll make that motion for you.
Okay, do we have a second?
I'll second that motion.
Any additional discussion? Skipco, and then we'll take it through and figure out what they'll bring, right?
Yes, yeah,
okay.
They charge us like $150 a car.
We've been successful, if I'm not mistaken, using them, so.
Yes.
Very good. Motion's been made, seconded. Call roll.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
That's all I have. Thank you.
Very good. Road department.
A couple things here. The first thing is we had the concrete is done. It'll be November 5th when the recycle bins will be opened back up.
Looks really nice.
Thanks. We're going to finish the asphalt work on the police side tomorrow morning.
Other items?
Next item I've got is, we had a bunch of trees that needed to be trimmed along the road on Lloyd and Michelle. I believe I asked to talk to you guys back in September about that or so. And Mr. Matthews, I got individual quotes for each property here. Total comes up to $5,450. I believe there's 11 properties.
Now, did we send that to the individuals?
We haven't. I just received them today. Mm. So that's why I'm bringing it to the board to see what the board wants to do here.
What are our options? Under your existing policy, you have three options. One, which is to order that the tree be removed from the right of way, and as a courtesy, provide the estimate that Jim has obtained to the property owner. Number two, you can declare the condition a nuisance and proceed to remove it yourselves, and then tax the cost as part of the tax recovery. Or three, the code allows you the flexibility to work out an arrangement with the property owner. Maybe you provide the labor or something, or you split the cost, that type of thing. It provides for some flexibility.
Now, would you have to do that uniformly then with all of them?
No, you can pick and choose from those three options that are allowed under both the code and the policy that you adopted under the code.
I think we just had another one somebody called me about. I think it was in the right of way. Do you remember where that was? Where was that?
I can't remember. I know. I thought
just recently they said what's in the right of way.
The problem that you had discussed before and actually very thoroughly addressed this is the function of the tree being in the right of way is kind of meaningless, except that it authorizes you to order it be removed. It doesn't make it your responsibility to bear the cost and take care of it. You can if you want, but you don't have to. We all know that if you just wind up doing this, you spend thousands of dollars every year handling these expenses that you again.
Are these people even aware that these trees need to be?
No, they are not. So. No. These are the ones they're doing damage to the trucks, pine trees and stuff. You can't plow. The road's going to be one lane plowed because we can't get over far enough without tearing the mirrors off and et cetera. So we're.
This could set a heck of a precedence if we just do it anywhere in the township.
Oh, you do it there, you're going to go somewhere else and do it. Or we go mow it, leave the mess there with the boom mower, and they can clean up the mess. Save them.
Well, I guess for me, I'm trying to think of a way to at least make them aware first. Definitely contact and make them aware of the situation and what we're up against. Also let them know, this is me, also let them know that we went ahead and got fixed, and here's the amount of money it will approximately cost you, the homeowner, for the work that needs to be done. I'm just talking this through and then letting them know that we need to hear back from them.
I would put a time limit on it.
Well, how many residents are there?
I believe there's 11.
And that's $5,000 and some. Quick math would tell you it's around $500 a piece.
Yeah, some of them, they range from $750 down to, I think, the lowest one's like $275.
I'd be willing to say if I got a notification from government that I owe them $750 for tree removal, I would probably not be a happy camper.
No, I was going to see if maybe send them a letter and see, you know, explain to them the deal and then also attach the quote.
Or maybe, and I'm not looking for additional time spent and stuff, but maybe even either get them here collectively or see if they can come to a meeting. I mean, sometimes letters, they're fine, but I don't know, maybe more personal contact would be better too. I'm not volunteering to do them all, but if one of my colleagues will go with me, we'll go up there and talk to them. I mean, if we're up against this, we're up against it. And if we just fire a letter, I mean, I'm not sure it will make any bigger impact or different impact, but I wouldn't be happy. I I know where Mr. Matthews is coming from as our legal counsel, and I know where you all are coming from as setting precedent, because I smelt that coming a long time ago when you brought it up. Because before I left, I got told about our road department not salting in an area, claiming they can't get the bed up on the truck because of trees. And I said, well, let's put it this way. We're getting ready to go in the funeral home for calling hours. Why don't you wait till I come back from vacation and we'll sit down and we'll talk about it. And it's up in that area. I don't think it's Lloyd, but it's up in that area. So that said, it's coming up, and maybe we'll be more and more present. So I think we need a little bit more talk about it, if it's all right with you guys. If you guys got a concrete set plan, but I'd kind of like to go through it and maybe think about, again, I just threw out a couple ideas, but not just send them a letter and say, hey, you know, your trees are in the way of our truck and we can't plow and we can't salt, and here, it's gonna cost $750 to take it down. How do you want to handle it? Or how do you want to pay for it?
What if we would, we almost have to send them a letter, we gotta call each one of them to come to a meeting, but what if we put it in there? Now we have the, we don't have the equipment to do the trimming.
Properly. Professionally.
We could use it with a mower. It won't look good, but we could do that for no cost.
And they would just have to clean up the debris.
Yeah, and see if they want to do that, or if they want to have, I agree, we have them come here. How would you get them here? Just call them, or would you actually?
Send a letter.
Send a letter.
Send a letter, ask them to come to the meeting.
Or contact us.
Yeah, organize a time that they feel that they can be here. You know, sometimes our meetings, it's because we're really hard to meet in, so. I mean, I think it's gonna crop up more and more and more. You see the trees, I mean, I drive them every, you know, you drive the streets, they're hanging over the road here on Wygant. And, you know, they're gonna. Yeah, I mean, if the trash trucks aren't knocking them down, we have issues with our trucks when the dumps go up to salt and all that, and it goes on and on and on, so.
Well, both of your approaches fit the third option, try to explore some agreement with the landowner.
Okay, then. I thank you, that lumps it into that. I would prefer that we do that rather than to us go in there and hack them up. We can, once we get them here, explain that here's our options, and we can make sure
some option.
We have it laid out. Which ones do you like?
The trimming help on some of the trees?
No, that's what it is. This is just.
No, trimming. It's not removing them. No.
No, this is just trimming. No, this is just trimming.
Whoa.
That's how. I mean, it's bad.
Whoa. Yeah, this is just trimming cost, isn't that? Yeah. You might spend, if it's a big tree, you could spend half of that just taking one out.
Oh, yeah.
So might end up killing them if it's those big pine trees.
It's the big pine trees.
You know, you get into the aesthetics, you get into the sentimental bit, you get into hack job, power company, you hear people say comes through and look at my beautiful tree, and so, well, let's continue. We gotta
address it.
Yes, and
we
so.
Need to make a motion to send letters?
No, we can discuss this and do something at the next meeting if you want to do that.
Yeah, let's continue to pursue it because we know it's coming, but
maybe
I
can get with Mr. Stevens and we can go up there one day. And
yeah, take a look. On a show like that, game plan, that everybody feels part of, you know, we got this problem, now we all solve it, versus here, you know, slap that on them. And I know you guys don't want to do that either.
No.
I'm not trying to sound like the good cop,
That's why I try to run all this stuff in front of you guys before we just.
Well, we appreciate that, sir.
Mr. Matthews, your PR skills Mr. Sims, your PR skills are coming along.
They are.
You're dumping it on us, so what else you got, sir?
I just have a drainage problem on Lafayette at the nursery.
Oh, I read that in the last.
So that was surveyed, and Mr. Matthews, what was that about the sign? If it's in the right of way, it's.
There is apparently a sign located within the right of way dimension, but Jim tells me it's not causing any issues.
No site issues or anything
no
like
visibility,
that.
No interference with road maintenance. So. He, as the road superintendent, is authorized to allow the sign to remain where it's at. There's no requirement that you order things like that to be removed. He has that flexibility. He could order it to be removed.
But there's no need. I mean, there's no site issue with that. It's just the tree that is to, like, the north. Is that or west? Northwest?
Northwest.
Yeah, of the property. That is going to need to be trimmed for this ditch that the resident doesn't want to pay for the pipe for access for his garage to drain his neighbor's water. So I could just tell him we're just gonna come through and open it up. If you wanna buy a pipe, this is what it is. If not, we can just open, we're just gonna leave an open ditch across the front of the property.
Very good.
If that's okay with the board.
Is that?
It is.
Okay.
Person that wants to use the roadway access has the responsibility to bear that cost for access.
Access onto their property, yes.
Okay.
If that works for the board, we'll just do that, and then if I got any problems, I'll
Well, it
have Chief Brown come out.
As long as we're on solid ground and you know, this is a there's two options, did I hear? One, you could pipe it.
Here's the picture, I don't know if you've seen the picture, that's the roadway.
Oh my.
Yeah, the water's flooding the road. We gotta do something before winter or we're gonna have ice problems and.
So you have to go down here and do some work?
Right through there, that's where that drive pipe is, and we just gotta open it up and clean the ditch out.
Okay, so you have to open up this drive pipe on this?
Property next to that.
Oh, back to the garage?
To that garage over there.
The garage?
Yes.
To allow the water to flow?
Yes, and then we gotta ditch down to the culvert that goes under the road.
Now.
Jim, I had sent you a letter form a while back, a month or so. Remember that, on what type of notice to give somebody if you're removing an existing obstruction?
Okay.
So I would follow that procedure.
Okay.
And I think under that procedure, you have to give them 5 days or something like that to.
Oh, yeah, we did that on another.
Yeah, I think that.
They have to be given a period of time to remediate themselves.
We are removing dirt and a culvert pipe here?
We're removing, yeah, the culvert pipe, basically.
It's collapsed, it needs to be replaced. So we're gonna remove it and just leave it open ditch.
Yes. I will call the resident first and explain
Uh-huh.
what we need to do, and then if they wanna fight the issue, then we'll go the other route. But if they don't, then I can just, they wanna pay for a pipe, we could just go do it like.
You'll be hearing.
I would still send the letter just to be safe.
Okay.
And whatever is in the letter, I don't have a version of it.
I don't have any.
I think it's 5 days they have.
Yeah, I have a paper trail.
Yeah, it's 5 days.
That's fine.
5 days.
5 days.
Okay.
Assuming they do nothing, then you're fully authorized.
In not to belabor, but you're sure that this issue back up here, all this flooding is a result of clogging down here?
Yeah, that's the only way it can drain.
Okay.
That's the drainage.
It's got to go that direction?
It's gotta go down, yes, it goes down, I don't know, 100 feet.
And then across?
And then goes under the road.
So what?
Over on the other side of the road, yes.
You gonna open the other side of the road too? Or is it open now?
It is open.
Oh, it is open?
Yes.
And the pipe underneath that it will go to?
Under the road is good, yes, we're gonna have to replace it next year, but it's good, it's full loose.
Okay.
It's just rotting out.
Because we'll maybe be challenged on a few of those things considering.
Yes, and he knows the pipe under the road, we're gonna replace that next year and put a basin in.
Okay.
In his yard where there's a big hole, and I explained it all to him when we were there before, so.
This is Murray?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So, all right, that's all I have, thank you.
Very good. Tony?
I have nothing to report this evening, Mike, but I would like to ask for a quick executive session after the meeting on a couple of potential legal matters with the board and Cindy and Mr. Matthews. And if it's okay, I'd like to have Sean Marion come in and he can, for some input he has towards.
Is this the one in North Lawrence?
Well, that would be one of them, yes, yes, sir.
Okay, I'll move that we have executive session with the zoning inspector and the, also the parties that were also asked to attend. They'll address zoning matters.
And that's all I have.
Second.
Call roll.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
One thing, sorry. Chief Brown and I would like to have a work session with the board after the meeting, brief, very brief.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm serious.
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious.
Wait, what, is this a work session?
Yes, after the meeting.
After?
About, maybe like a 15-minute meeting, that's all it is, yes.
After the executive session?
Yes, you can.
Oh, okay, you're not pulling my leg.
No, a work session.
All right.
It'll be brief.
Police and road.
Yes, it's going on projects here around.
A work session, not an executive session?
Work session.
After the meeting?
After the meeting.
After our executive session.
Okay, just so I get the litany of this whole thing, and you are serious?
Yes, I am, that's Chief Brown, he'll tell you too.
Are you serious?
Yes, sir.
All right, I'm not gonna prove it, you guys, go ahead.
I'll make that motion, have a work session with the road and police department immediately following the meeting.
Mr. Mr. Camp?
Following the executive session?
Yeah, no, I'm sorry.
After the meeting.
After the meeting, yeah.
Oh, I saw that. I think that's what you said.
I think that's what I said.
Mr. Camp?
Yes.
Mr. Lockhart?
Yes.
Mr. Stevens?
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
I didn't vote yet. These things have to be unanimous. You call that a unanimous, yes. Okay. Having enough of that nonsense, Mr. Stevens. Public speaks, or Matthews, or Mr. Matthews first, our attorney. Other items from our legal?
Well, the Stevens properties issues are proceeding, and I understand some of the representatives may be here to talk to you about those properties.
Okay. Are there any representatives in the crowd? Care to say anything, sir? If you could come up front and identify yourself, please. Your name and address.
My name is Winfield Stevens. I live in Massillonet, 1240 North. My parents.
Say that address again.
1240 North, Massillon. I'm the property of Strasser.
Yes, sir.
My parents died about 5 years ago. I had no acknowledgement of the rights that I had on the property or anything else. My brother and sister were in a fight about it. And at the time, I washed my hands of the property because I didn't want to fight with them or fight with the family anymore. So that's the reason why the property looks the way it is.
Okay.
I mean, I just wanted to make it clear.
Okay. You are aware that we are trying to move to clean it up?
Yes. I've been up there past a week cleaning up and doing what I could do up there, but...
Okay.
I mean, I've put in $3,000 of my own money into the property trying to clean it up, and with no help from my brother and sister. But yet, you know, I don't want to go in there and do something and then to come back and say, hey, well, I want the property now, and then it'll just be a big fight again.
Well, we certainly would want to fuel your fire on that, but are you aware of where we are at and what we're pursuing?
No, that's why I'm here today.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now that is where I would like Mr. Matthews, if he could give you a brief overview of where things are at for Mr. Maligo,
yeah.
Combined, if he has anything to add. We are pursuing what you're doing pretty diligently because it needs to be. You're very aware of that.
Yeah, oh yeah, of course.
So,
yeah.
With that said, why Mr. Matthews?
Just real quick, Bill, which there's two properties out there. Can we just identify the address just for...
So 10445.
10445, okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the board previously, and you and I spoke on the phone, I'm Jim Matthews. The board previously declared the conditions on both properties to be a nuisance and then directed me as your agent to serve notice as required by the code. So I served the notice, we got certified mail service on the siblings with regard to the property you're mentioning. And to their credit, including you, all three of them called me, all your siblings called me, when they received the letters. I just kind of wanted to say that they too are interested in getting the property cleaned up.
Yeah, but none of them's been up here to help do anything since day one.
We understand you're kind of in a weird state of limbo over the property. What I did determine from speaking with the three of you, though, is that your father had previously died and mm-hmm. left the property to your mother.
No, it's still in my grandmother's name.
Oh, grandma.
My grandmother had sold it to my mother.
Okay. And then your mother died, and she died without a will,
mm-hmm.
which meant that as a matter of Ohio law, the property was deemed transferred to the three of you equally
mm-hmm.
at the time of her death. So that's where it stands. If you want to verify that, memorialize that, there's a procedure you can do that in front of the probate court. I think I told you that I'd kind of walk you through that process
yeah.
if you're interested. But that's something that the township is not interested in doing itself.
Mm-hmm.
It just wants the property cleaned up. So one route is for the board to go ahead and proceed with the cleanup at this point. The cost that would be involved would be placed on the tax duplicate for reimbursement to the township.
Mm-hmm.
So that's an option that's available to you and your siblings. Or the preference would be to just reach some agreement, right, where the property gets cleaned up within a certain period of time.
But then all the responsibilities and all the obligations go on to me because neither one of them two are going to come up to help do anything. So therefore, if the property doesn't get cleaned up,
yeah.
I'm the one still going to get fined for it.
Well, yeah, there's no fines involved, this is just kind of cost of the cleanups.
Well, still, I'm gonna be responsible for the cost of cleanup.
Well, who is paying taxes, if you don't mind me asking?
I was paying them there for a while, until my brother and sister didn't wanna help out, so then I stopped everything.
Well, this really gets into a kind of a lecture about real estate law that'll bore everybody. But what the law recognizes you as is co-tenants, the three of you own the property jointly.
Can I sell my portion off without them?
You actually could.
Get out from underneath them?
You actually could, but good luck trying to find a market where somebody's gonna wanna buy that one-third interest in the property. I just don't see that happening as a practical matter. But the, without trying to make this too complicated, the Ohio real estate law recognizes the three of you as joint tenants. So you're equally responsible for one-third of the cost. If you were to pay the entire tax bill, you would have a right to collect from the, from your siblings, their respective shares, okay? I don't know if you're interested in doing that, or you wanna pursue that avenue, but that's something that you have the right to do. You also.
The property is probably, it's probably better off just doze it over and call it done.
Okay, well, that's certainly an option that I think the township would accept, if you're inclined to do that, within some reasonable period of time. They just felt, and not speaking for the board, but just telling you what they did, is they felt that they had waited long enough to try and get this resolved. They needed to try and advance it and get it cleaned up. I think they're prepared to go ahead with the cleanup and then wait to collect it. But the preference would be to get cooperation from you and your sibling.
I mean, you can go up there and see, I've been up there, you know, trying to make improvements on the place.
Sean and I agree that you've done.
You know, and, you know, it's been me and my son up there, you know, and that's, you know, and my wife, and that's, you know, we're the only ones that's been up there trying to do anything with the place.
Yeah, well, what would you prefer that the board do? Just go ahead with the cleanup, or?
I don't know, I don't wanna get stuck with a bill. I mean, that's the thing.
Well, are you willing to go ahead and proceed with cleaning it up and then try to recoup the money from your siblings?
No, because I know I'll never get it back from them.
Okay, well, then we have ourselves a, what's this, a Mexican standoff or something?
I don't know what to do, you know?
And I know you're in the middle of it.
I don't wanna have to, you know, put up all the, you know, money to clean this place out, and then my brother and sister be like, oh, you cleaned it out, okay, well, we're moving in here now. And then, where am I at?
Yeah. I can tell you that in speaking with your siblings, they expressed the same thing you're telling us, that they were interested in having the property cleaned up. I don't know if the three of you communicate or are willing to get together to figure this out.
I tried calling them, texting them, everything, months, and no response, no answer. I mean, it is what it is. I mean,
well, the only message I can end with is, it's time to get this over with, because it's just gone on too long.
Either way you do it, you're gonna pay your third.
That's true.
If you sell it, I mean, say you pay to clean it up, you'll get your third, you know, you'll get theirs deducted. In other words, am I right?
That's true.
Yeah.
It should all kind of balance out at the end of the day. If you were to put more money into it and then sell it, you would be entitled to get more of it back from your co-tenants, if that explained to you. But again, these are all things that have to be forced. And if somebody's not going to agree to do this, you need to use court procedures to force them to do that.
Yeah.
And, that's what you ought to do.
I don't know, my hands are tied with it, I guess.
There's also a procedure for you to seek a, basically a division of the interest, which means if they don't want to buy you out, then you can sell it and get your money out. But that's another provision in the law that provides a remedy.
All right.
Well, do we want to set a time window on all of this?
I think you should, because you've gone this far to move along.
We're grateful for you to come in and help us out here face to face.
Yeah.
Now that we have you, I don't know what's a reasonable amount of time to bring this thing to a point where, if you've gotten it as far as you can and your siblings aren't moving on it, that we go in and we finish the job, and once you sell it, here's what you owe the township collectively, not just you personally, but the group, and whatever
under the one, any of this, if you haven't already.
If you were to clean it up, how much time would you need to clean it? I don't know what's left up there.
At least 2 weeks.
Well, that'd be cheap.
Well, I'm, Frank, you had something?
Yeah, what type of things are there?
Just, there's,
old refrigerators?
No,
appliances?
Nothing like that.
What's there?
Basically, where my dad having the garbage businesses.
Solid waste.
Yeah, garbage and.
So there's no, value, scrap value in anything there?
No.
I think it would pay you to go ahead and do that and recoup it.
Yeah, cause I mean, I was looking into it, it probably, all it's there is probably maybe an 18-yard dumpster full of, you know, stuff there that, you know, they, that's, you know, and then the weeds and stuff in the back and, you know, the brush and stuff that needs cleaned up, but other than that.
What about the van?
That I don't know how to get rid of because it has no title and nobody accepts vehicles without titles.
Well, I found somebody that will.
Yeah.
So who have, but there again, I believe that that van is one-third ownership of his also because it's an asset. Cause it does have scrap value. Is that my memory right there? I don't know.
Well, could we take the van, scrap it, and put whatever money's to that van straight towards the dumpster, not even go towards me or anybody else?
Your sister claims that she owns the van, so you've got a little fight going on with them. But the township, it's permitted to just have the thing removed and scrapped, so.
Okay.
If somebody wants it, you guys need to work it out.
I don't want it.
If you guys can't work this stuff out, the township's just gonna have to get it cleaned up.
Exactly. Well, now you see what I'm going through.
I understand, yeah.
If you said it, you said a couple weeks, and this is October 22nd, right?
Yeah.
If we look at, that's 2 weeks is our next meeting, which would be November 5th. If that place is cleaned up by November 5th, I'll buy you dinner. with Mr. Camp.
Yeah, I'll help.
But in all sincerity, 2 weeks, that's aggressive, and I've been by there before. I know it's been cleaned up some now since I've been by, but
yeah.
How about if we go with that 2 week date and see what's taking place, and then if you need a little bit longer, but I want to get this thing resolved, and if we aren't prepared to set a drop dead date tonight, we'll look at the progress our next meeting and
go from there.
And go from there.
Okay.
We appreciate your efforts, and this has been a long, long process.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming in.
Could we get a phone number? Would that be okay? If
yeah,
the township has a phone number, so
sure.
We need to contact.
Well,
you can give it to
the Chris right now. If you don't mind giving that one, we'll have it.
Sure. It's 330-834-5525.
Mr. Matthews, so just to belabor it, what can we do with the van? I've been trying to get rid of that van for years, and I'm always getting that same. I can tell you one thing, that what Mr. Matthews said to you, I personally can say he's right on the money. Your family, the other two folks, they want to get rid of it. They don't want to continue this. It sounds to me like no one wants to continue it, but no one wants to do anything about it.
Exactly.
And you know, you can understand where we are.
Oh, I understand it, yeah.
So I don't know if I'm just giving you some maybe hints that you, I think you would be surprised to find out that you do share the same goal. You guys do. I've talked to, and everybody shares the same goal. And everybody's concerned about the same thing that you have told us, that they don't want to do anything and end up being accused of theft or something like that. You know, you took my part, same thing with the van.
Yeah.
And just let me tell you, if you can work something out, I can get rid of that. I found somebody that will take that van. Because we got rid of the truck, with that was that same deal. It was no title and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the police chief here, but I won't tell you. No, it isn't. I don't want to get
it. I honestly don't care who it is.
No,
that's
not
true.
So anyways,
one more step for me.
If you have any questions, just give us a call, or you can give my office a call.
Okay.
But I'm in agreement with all of that, by the way.
Okay.
But what is your long-term goal?
I'd love to get that house. I mean, I'd like to live in Canal 4 again. We live in Massillon, and honestly, I don't like Massillon. The school system out there for my kids or not. I'd rather be back in Northwest, you know, where I went to school at, and, you know, be back in a, you know, a good community where it's not the crime and the crap that goes on in that stuff.
You long term, you would want to live there then?
Yes, I would.
Okay, that would be refurbishing the house and doing some things on that too.
Mm-hmm.
That's a step in the right direction.
Are you sure that house can be? I mean, I think that house needs to be demoed.
See, I do too, and I'd like to have that, you know, have that done and brought in, you know, the modular home and everything.
So you'd be looking at a demo cost too. I mean, and that's all doable, but I mean, I think that's why he asked you what your long term goal is, because it could be turned into a valuable, you know, piece of real estate.
Mm-hmm.
But that house, I'm pretty sure, needs. I don't think you're going to be able to.
Well, that would have to be just a well.
Yeah, decided on later day.
I know that would be the final step.
Yeah.
And that's not quite as important as what you.
Well, that's interesting to know that you'd like to. You know, it's Mr. Lockhart asked that question. That's an interesting comment. So hopefully that comes to fruition for you.
I'm very sorry.
You go here.
If I take this right, you're going to go ahead and pursue the 2-week goal, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So we'll be watching.
And then in the meantime, too, I will follow up with a letter just kind of outlining for you what you need to file in the probate court.
Okay.
To bring that to a head.
Awesome.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're other welcome. Public speaks? Mayor, anything to add to the situation?
Rita said that I can't keep my mouth shut, so she said that I'm going to say something, so she made me sign the book. I'm going to prove her wrong. Just if the board has any questions for me about anything going on in the city, I'll try to answer.
Mm-hmm. I guess since I've been gone, I read somewhere where Corman Railroad challenged your annexation.
Not aware of that.
Oh, okay. I don't know where I live yet. But
yeah, they sent a letter.
I'm sorry?
They sent a letter.
Oh, okay.
They may not have sent it to the city.
Going through my mail. Okay, well,
I'll be looking for it.
Maybe I'm telling you something that I shouldn't be telling you.
That's why we're here, Mike. And then recycling seems to be pretty good. I don't know if you've heard from your residents. So just
no, I've been out of town, so thank you for that.
But it's
up and running then.
Yeah, it's up and running, and so if we on Facebook, if people have branches, and especially when you're talking about that, if someone cuts those limbs down, and there's some place for them to haul them to again.
Very good.
Thank you very much.
Well, that's good to know. Thank you, because I didn't see anything in any indication of anything that it had opened. Of course, I've been gone.
Very good. What's the address of that?
960 Milan Street.
960 Milan. Yeah, we'll need that.
So you were right.
We can get that in the paper. We appreciate that. Any additional information to be brought before the board before we go into executive session? Hearing none, we're into executive session. Heading to
it. Where's your sister?
Okay, Frank, brief.